That happens later. I didn't like that setup. So I like to talk, but I always like to play first. So what I wanted to tell you about the last piece, it was one of the last pieces, it was the last piece that Debussy wrote. He was one of the first people to actually. It was hard. It's not, you're right, it is hard. He was one of the first people to actually have a colorectal operation, one of the first people to receive a colostomy. So that's how long ago that was. It was at the end of his life in the throes of World War I. He was miserable, he was sick. He, his own quote, it was his last completed work and the first performance, May 5th, 1917, was his last concert in Paris. And this is Debussy's quote. I only wrote this sonata to be rid of the thing. Spurred on by my dear publisher, this sonata will be interesting from a documentary point of view and as an example of what may be produced by a sick man in a time of war. So these notes are incredible. I forgot the guy's name. They come from the Los Angeles Philharmonic. I'll get his name in the second part. About the Szymanowskis, Szymanowski was obviously Polish. This was written before the Second World War, shortly before the Russian Revolution, and he was living in a town that today would be found in Ukraine. So we didn't get hacked by the Russians for this music. So. It's an incredible piece. I would call it rhapsodic for sure. Post-romantic impressionism. It sort of falls right between Debussy being the impressionist as in terms of, if you think of paintings of Monet, Manet, and that would be Debussy's work, and this is shortly before that, in between Brahms and Debussy. So, best of both worlds.
Thank you.
I have a book upstairs, which if I see any of you after the concert, I'll remember what the other movies are. But one of my favorite movies, Ocean's 11, at the Bellagio, when the fountains are going, that's Debussy's Clair de Lune, I think. And this is also from his Preludes. And this is, you have a program, right? But I like saying the title. La fille aux cheveux de lin, the girl with the flaxen hair. Excuse me? Oh, because I was being normal. I like this one a lot. I first heard it, Heifetz played it on his last recital, and what is that? These are both originally piano pieces, so I owe my wife many, many tennis lessons, many tennis hitting sessions for agreeing to play these with me, because in the piano versions they're both half step lower. Half step lower. My favorite thing about this is the title, which translates as the slower than slow. But it's a sort of, there's a moment in it, speaking of music, movie music, in the Jack Nicholson Batman, the waltz, when the Joker is dancing the waltz, there's a sort of Shostakovich Debussy crossover moment there. You'll get it. Thank you. This is one of those from my youth. I was scared of it then, and I'm scared of it now. So, oh, do you know? Legend has it. You're about to learn. This is not fake news. This is legend. If you are bitten by a tarantula and you dance the tarantella, you will rid yourself of the effects of the venom. Just ask Dr. Bob.
Thank you. Thank you.
not going to let you go that easy. Ah,
maybe we are. Oh, hell with it.
I know this piece. So this is, to my mind, one of the absolutely most beautiful pieces in our repertoire. It's called the Chant de Roxane, the Song of Roxane, by Szymanowski. It's from his opera King Roger. It was written, it's transcribed by Kochanski. So there's more than a, in case you didn't already realize, I'm half Polish heritage. That's why the W is like a V. In my last name, Niva. Anyway, so Paweł Kochański transcribed this from the opera King Roger, Szymanowski's opera King Roger. And another connection is my former teacher at Curtis, Aaron Rosan, played on the Kochański del Jesu, which was a Guarnerius del Jesu violin that was made in 1744. And he recently sold it to a Russian collector for $10.5 million. Yeah. If I had $10.5 million, I would have bought it.